Bonjour! Hi! Welcome to another video of Cloud in 5 Minutes. Let me introduce myself. I'm Frank Boucher, Microsoft Azure MVP, based in Montreal in Canada. And today, I want to show you how to add one of those Deploy to Azure buttons for your repository or any website you want. You'll see, it's very simple. Okay. So to get started, we'll start with the simplest scenario and then we'll add a little bit more complexity in it. So to get started, I have a GitHub repository. I will show you how to do it also in any web page you want. But for now, I just created an empty repository called Simple Test, and I specified that I want a README. That's what show up by default on GitHub, and that's where we will add our Deploy to Azure button. So we'll clone the environment on my machine. So let's do it right now. PowerShell, so git clone. Now I'll go in Simple Test, voila. We'll open it in VS Code. Okay, so I have an empty page. So let's create our website. So for that, we'll open the terminal and we'll create a simple .NET MVC, also .NET new, and then I will use the template MVC. It will create a website for me. Perfect, now I will just go in the controller and we'll change the message so we know it's our website. Voila, we'll save this. Okay, perfect. And now if I'm running it with .NET run, and if we go in about. So, hello from 5 minutes, Cloud in 5 minutes. So it is our website. Perfect. And go back to Visual Studio Code. Excellent. Now, let's stop it. Perfect. And we'll close the terminal. Don't need it anymore. Okay. So now what I want to do is add this Deploy to Azure button. So I will go in the README file and I'll just add a new URL. So this URL, I'm using Markdown here. If you are in a regular web page, you're just using the HTML markup. So Deploy to Azure, that's the text. And then I'm using an image. In fact, this website here, deploytoazure.net, is where you will see a lot of instruction documentation about how to do it. So, and then I'm sending the page to azuredeploy.net. So we'll do that and save it. Of course, I need an MVC app. We'll add everything, just commit, and we'll push it to Git. Perfect, so now let's go back in GitHub, and if I refresh the page, I should see my code. Yes, it is, and if I scroll, ta-da, this is our button. Let's try it right away. I told you it was easy. So what happened? We just get redirect to deploy.azure.com. So because I was already connected in the portal.azure.com, it knows who I am, and then it showed me my directory, my subscription, and it knows already all my resource group that I have in my subscription. Otherwise, it will just have, you know, this pop-up login and I will enter my credential. Just to save you time, that's why I was already connected. Perfect. So now I could keep it like that, just rename it something like this. Perfect. Let's use this. Click next. Click deploy. Perfect. So now what happened is Kudu. So Kudu is a tool, a command tool that will help you to deploy. So what it does, it will synchronize your repository to another repository that will be local in Azure. And then it will use the code and try to push it in a web app. If it works, like in our case, you will just have a new website. If not, then you will have an error. I will show you how to have a little bit more control in the next steps. But for now, let's wait this deployment. Perfect, look like the deployment is already done. So let's navigate to this website. Because it's the first time, of course, it's a little bit longer, and then I need to accept my policies. Perfect. And now if I go in about, yes, it is our website. Excellent. So if we go in Azure, I could refresh that, and now I see that a simple test resource group has been created, and I have my app and a plan. Great. That was nice. But what if you want a little bit more control, or maybe your solution required more than only one website? And honestly, that's probably the case most of the time, right? So in Azure, we have the ARM template, and I spoke about them multiple times. I will put the link in the description if you don't know what's ARM template and how to use it. So what you need to do is you go back, let's go back in our project, and you need to add a new ARM template. It must be called Azure Deploy.json. And now you just have to build your ARM template. By default, if you specify values, default values, or selection of option in your parameter section, that will be used to populate your form in the Azure Deploy.net web page. So that could be very convenient. Maybe you know that your database required something a little bit more beefy than the free SKUs. So you could specify them. So by default, it will take that. Another thing that you could do is specify some parameter. So let's say here, I'm using the same button than before, but I will add a little bit more values in my query string. So for example, I will specify my repository. So you put the link of your repository, and with the parameter template, you could use a relative path to my file. So here it's at my root, so parameter.azuredeploy.json, or the complete URL if your parameter file is somewhere else. What you could do with those two is specify specific value in the parameter file, let other with options, and then it will help your user to fill up and ease that experience of deployment in their own subscription. Because the goal is in fact just to help people to deploy your code, right? So with that, it will help. Now the next scenario is when you have something a little bit more complex. Maybe you would like to deploy a database, yes, but then you want to run some script, or you need some DLL or package to be installed in the Azure and the Kudu interface. So to do that, you will need to override the default deployment. The starting point is to create a new file again, and you will call it .deployment. There you could put many different instructions. One of them is to override the config, and you specify the command. With this command, Kudu will know that it needs to run the deploy.toAzure command. In this file, you could have installed different packages that are needed, or you could even start your build. So here you could use many different tools and have the total control of your deployment. To see one of those a little bit more complex deployment, have a look to CoreWiki. It's a project from C# Fritz where I help him to add this button. In that, I will use an override deployment file, and then I will use Cake, because Cake was the tool that Jeff was already using. I use Cake with Kudu to deploy his website. You'll see it's very convenient and very powerful. I hope you liked this video, and I hope it was useful. If it was your first Cloud in 5 Minutes, then know that every second week I publish short video to answer technical questions. And if you're like me, you will probably forget. So don't hesitate to subscribe. This way you won't miss any other video. To know more about .NET Core and all the functionality of CoreWiki, have a look to the C# Fritz channel just here, and down below, another video of Cloud in 5 Minutes. Thank you for watching. See you next time.